thank you all. And I have the pleasure of presenting the first annual, which means we're going to do this again, Rusty Staub Award to someone who is a devoted supporter of this organization and who I spent nearly every waking hour with him for many, many years. It seems like longer than it was, I tell you. Ed Skyler. But before I bring Ed to the stage, let me just say a few words about the guy whose name is on the award. Long before I ran for mayor, I was fortunate to work with Rusty as a board member. Rusty was a New York icon, and when he established this fund, he became a hero's hero. Rusty was here at the very beginning, and it was his idea. Rusty understood that day in and day out, New York's finest and bravest and their families take care of us. And when we lose one of them, it is up to us to take care of their families. And that's what we're trying to do here. We owe it to them, and we owe it to everyone that they loved. Rusty's heart, if you didn't know him, was bigger than his swing even, and he cared so much for the families that this fund serves, and I know we're all thinking of him tonight. And Ed Skyler is the perfect person to receive the inaugural Rusty Staub Award this year, not just because he's a huge Mets fan. Ed, look at the bright side. If the Mets had had a better season, they would be playing tonight, and you'd be missing the game. Seriously, Ed has been on the board of the fund since leaving City Hall about 8 years ago, and I have no doubt that his time in government is what led him to join the board. For 8 years, Ed was by my side during emergencies, first as press secretary, then as deputy mayor. And when I got a call at 3 a.m. because a police officer, a firefighter, had been killed protecting us, I would go to the hospital, and so would Ed. He saw what families went through. He felt their heartache, he went to their funerals, and he never forgot those experiences. They leave you with a deep sense of gratitude for our finest and our bravest and their families, and Ed has inherited that as much as anybody I know. During our time at City Hall, we did everything in our power to protect the men and women in uniform and make sure that they could get home safely. And Ed played a key role in that work. He worked closely with Commissioner Kelly and Commissioners Scapetta and Cassano to make sure the police and fire department had the resources and the support they needed to keep our city safe. Whether it was modernizing our 911 system or working to secure federal aid for health care for everyone who responded to the terrorist attacks on 9/11, Ed always went the extra mile. Ed, you should know, was also instrumental in our fight against illegal guns. We created a national coalition of mayors who supported common sense gun laws. Back then, people told us, you'll never beat the NRA. Well, in recent years, many times we have, and we're going to do it more. And Ed helped lay the ground foundation for that progress. Ed was deeply devoted to the city, and he worked around the clock. Once, this is a true story, he even chased down a mugger in the street and held him until the police could survive, and the tabloids dubbed him Batman. I was really annoyed. I was the one that should have grabbed the guy and thrown him down. The fact that I wasn't there had nothing to do with it. Anyways, Ed truly went above and beyond for the people of Gotham on public safety and many other issues. He was instrumental in developing policies and strategies that made New York not only safer, but also cleaner, healthier, and greener. And our administration, along with the entire city, benefited enormously from Ed's mastery of issues and his superhuman service. Ed left City Hall for the private sector back in 2010, but he's never stopped contributing to important civic causes. He chairs the Citizens Budget Commission, and serving on this is one of his passions. He's also still making our city and the whole country safer through his work at Citigroup. Earlier this year, after the Parkland massacre, where 17 kids were killed on February 14th, Citigroup adopted some common sense restrictions on their business clients that sell guns, such as no sales to anyone under 21, no sales to anyone who hasn't passed a background check, and no sales of bump stocks or high-capacity magazines. Now, you know, life ain't easy, and difficult things make it hard to do. But Citibank has taken a lot of heat for the gun lobby for that decision, but they have never backed down. Ed and his boss, Mike Corbett, and everyone at Citibank deserves a lot of credit for that. A nice round of applause for them. Now, I began supporting the fund long before I became mayor, and I've known Ed almost as long. In fact, I've known Ed since he was only 6'3". I thought that was funnier than you did. You've never stood next to him. I mean, it hurts your neck talking to the guy. He originally came to work at our company, and people said Ed looked down on me, which was technically correct. But the qualities that endeared Ed to me the most were his wise counsel and his total honesty. He was never afraid to tell me when I screwed up, and let's say he didn't lack for opportunities. But his heart was always in the right place. And as his wife Jan and their two daughters can tell you, Ed has a very big heart. Although, as every reporter can tell you, I tested the strength of his heart every time I got behind a microphone. And he's probably feeling that way now. So let's welcome to the stage a great New Yorker and the perfect person to receive the inaugural Rusty Staub Award, Ed Skyler.
Thanks, Mike. By the way, have you been out switching parties again? All right. In all seriousness, your legacy in mayor has basically shaped the city that we are living in today. After 9/11, you made the city safer from both crime and terrorism. You made the city stronger economically. You made it more sustainable and healthier, no matter what the political cost to you. In fact, your administration has become the model for independent and effective city government. In addition to other things, I'm grateful for your introducing me to this wonderful organization. Few people have done as much for the families of fallen first responders as you have, and I do want to share one story. In 2006, when we were in City Hall, a disturbing discovery was made. Human remains were found at the World Trade Center site. Mike immediately authorized a renewed search to make sure no one else was missed during the original recovery effort. Now, you have to remember that at that point, the Trade Center was a construction site, and there was tremendous pressure to get things done on time and on budget. But Mike said to me very clearly, search where you have to search, close what you have to close, spend what you have to spend. We have to get this right. That is the man who I worked for 10 years. There are many other people here that are also committed to public safety. I want to acknowledge some of our former colleagues in the Bloomberg administration, including Commissioner Cassano, Commissioner Nigro, Commissioner Kelly, and also retired Inspector Dunn and retired Lieutenant Brendan from the NYPD Intelligence Division, who made sure we were safe as we went about our jobs. It is also a real honor to receive the first award named after our founder, Rusty Staub. As Mike said, this was one of the first organizations I got involved with after I left city government, and I was lucky to spend some time with Rusty. But I was even luckier that Rusty didn't remember me from the sixth grade. Because Rusty, as you know, in addition to being an amazing ball player, loved food and was a restaurateur. And one of his restaurants was located around the corner from where I went to school, and it was right in front of the bus stop. So my friends and I would sit on the stoop in front of the restaurant and wait for the bus. But really, we were hoping for Rusty to come out And half the reason we were hanging out there was we knew he would come out and shoo us away. It was sort of like the Manhattan equivalent of get off my lawn. So I do feel like, Rusty, I owe you an apology. So if you're listening, I'm very, very sorry. In all seriousness, this organization is important to me because of what it represents. It sends a message. It sends a message to the brave police officers and firefighters, the citizens of this city care about you. We value what you do. And if the unthinkable happens, we will be there to help the loved ones who relied on you. But it is more personal than a social compact. I do think I remember the name of every firefighter and police officer we lost during the 8 years I worked in City Hall. Those hours Mike mentioned, which we spent in hospitals, they were hard to endure, because you knew those families were finding out that the worst nightmare had come true and their lives were going to be changed forever. And despite all the resources we had at their at our disposal, there was nothing we could do to change that. And for me, it did come down to something Ray Kelly said one night when we were in St. Vincent's Hospital in Staten Island. It was 2003 when detectives James Nemeron and Rodney Andrews had been murdered during an undercover operation to get guns off the street. For whatever reason, at that moment, it was just the two of us sitting there. It was quiet. It was morose. There was no rationalizing or explaining what had happened that night. Ray simply said, "It's a dangerous business." What else can you really say? It's a foolish task to try to make these jobs something they're not. They are not safe. Running into burning buildings, pursuing criminals, these jobs are fundamentally dangerous. But those among us who choose them as a profession deserve to have the peace of mind that this organization helps create. So I thank you very much for this honor, and more importantly, I thank you for supporting this incredible organization and the families who rely on it. Have a great night.